Hey everyone! Welcome to the first video in my little mini tutorial series. I'm starting small with these videos to build confidence in teaching. In this tutorial, I'll show you how I made Terriermon's cheek controller. The main tool here is the Lattice modifier. Let me show you how it works using a simple object like sphere. When you create Lattice object, do not scale, move or rotate the lattice in edit mode to align it with your mesh. Always make transformations in object mode instead. If you change the lattice in edit mode, the lattice modifier will deform your model incorrectly when it's applied. A lattice is a very powerful tool. Whatever controls the lattice point also controls the shape of the mesh using the lattice. To increase the lattice resolution, head over to the Lattice Data Properties panel. There you'll see three values, U, V, W. U is the x-axis, V is the y-axis, W is the z-axis. Set the resolution you want depending on how detailed your deformation needs to be. Now let's answer the question, how do we control the lattice with the bones? You might be thinking, can we just weight paint directly onto the lattice? Well, we can't. The lattice object doesn't support weight painting like meshes do. It only has edit mode and object mode. But here's the workaround. Go to the lattice data properties, and you'll find something called vertex groups. That's our solution. You can manually create vertex groups and assign weights to each point. Here's how I did it. I gave the center points a full weight of 1. The outer points got something like around 0.7 to 0.8. Then I gradually added weights to the surrounding points for a smooth circular falloff. This creates a smooth deformation when the lattice is moved. Now that we've got the vertex weights, we can link them to a bone using a hook modifier. To do that, we need to add a hook modifier to the lattice, assign the armature and specific bone you want to use, choose the vertex group you just made, and that's it. Now the bone can control the lattice which deforms the mesh. Here's the cool part. You can deform any part of the model connected to that lattice modifier. To give yourself more control, let's add a parent bone above the lattice controller. Let's call it master lattice. Parent the lattice object directly to this master lattice bone. In object mode, select the lattice, then shift select the armature. Go into pose mode, select the bone you want, and press Ctrl P and bone. Now you can move the lattice controller for detailed deformation and move the master lattice to affect the whole structure globally. This gives you layered control over the deformation. This is a super useful method if you want to add extra flexibility or expressive movement to your characters. And the best part? It's non-destructive. You're not changing the mesh itself, just using modifiers. Just one note, this method works best with high resolution topology. If your mesh is too low poly, you won't get smooth results. Anyway, that's pretty much it. I hope you found this helpful. If this one does well, I might make more short, step-by-step tutorials like this. You can support me on Patreon, and if you have any feedback, drop it in the comments so I can improve these tutorials. See you in the next one.